Distracted Driving by Sydney Gunter.
Don't have the radio loud. Don't read while driving. Eating and drinking is not allowed. Hello, hello is not allowed either. Texting and driving is a definite no. Hey, how are y'all? My hands weren't even on the wheel.
Driving happens each day, much more than it should. Teen drivers get blamed much too often. It's everyone. As I drive to school each day, I see many people on their phone, yelling at their kids, eating breakfast, doing their makeup, and even with headphones in. Just because you're late doesn't mean that you should take a life because you have to do your makeup. 24% of teens know the dangers of texting and driving, but 35% do it anyways. While looking away for 5 seconds, you can go a length of a football field if you're going 55 miles per hour. You can do a lot of damage going the length of a football field. There are 3 different types of distracted driving. Visual, your eyes aren't off the road. Manual, your hands are off the road. And cognitive, your brain is not in the driving. Texting and driving is all 3, visual, manual, and cognitive. 9 people die each day from distracted driving. 1,000 people get injured each day because of distracted driving. In 2015 alone, 42% of high schoolers admitted to distracted driving. This increases the rate that they aren't wearing a seatbelt, they are drinking and driving, or getting in the car with someone who has been drinking and driving. Over 64% of accidents involve distracted driving. Out of those accidents, 1 of 4 are because of texting and driving. 77% of adults and 55% of teens believe they can handle texting and driving. Technological ways that we can stop distracted driving is by making a law that car mode has to be installed and used on each cell phone. It turns off all notifications and does not let your phone light up, receive calls, or get text messages. Also, it shuts down all social media apps so that you cannot use social media and drive. Another app turns it off at 5 miles per hour, and then if you were to stop and have to call for any emergency reason, you can get on it. Some practical ways we can stop distracted driving is each parent sitting down with their child before they get in the car, to always stand up to other people distracted driving, and to stop your own child from distracted driving. We can also put our phone physically in the back seat. This stops distracted driving because you cannot reach over an inch to get your phone. It's in the back and you can't see what's going on. Driving ultimately doesn't just affect you, but everyone around you. A text should not be worth taking someone else's life. It's up to each person to pledge to themselves and each other that they will stop distracted driving. I ask you to pledge with me, Sydney Gunter, to stop distracted driving, to promise to ourselves and each other that we will not distracted drive in our own cars, and other cars, when we see it, we will say something.